Don't miss the celebration of spring with the upcoming Boysenberry Festival, April 1st through the 23rd.
Well, we ain't missing it again. Greetings, salutations, and all around, how the hell are you? Welcome to this adventure of ours. We're finally on our way to the Knott's Berry Farm Boysenberry Festival.
Blah, blah, blah. Feels like I open every outing video like this, so let's switch it up a bit. Back in 2017, Haley and I visited Knott's Berry Farm to check out their annual celebration of the humble berry that Walter named after the guy who first grew them. Because A, the alternative would be reserved for a family of fictional bears, and B, there was only enough room in Orange County for one monster named Walt. Much like your typical food and wine festival, they have a wide array of offerings. Only here, it's new and interesting ways one can consume the boysenberry. You might remember the little jab I made at this.
Come on down to the Boysenberry Festival every spring!
This particular year was the introduction of the boysenberry ravioli and pizza, as well as the inclusion of gator bites with a boysenberry aioli. And yes,
ketchup! Barbecue sauce!
Of course, there was another reason for our trip. We needed to conquer the FUN BUN!
I do say conquer, because according to reports from Dave, Mr. Doggins himself, it's a pretty hefty piece of pastry.
We'll meet you guys at Knott's.
We'll meet you guys at Knott's. Bye.
We're on the berry farm!
This is awesome!
Look at that, is decked out.
I know!
I hear a toot toot. Let's go to the toot toot. It's like it's like their own little Founders Fair or Founders Day Fair or whatever.
This is why I want to take you to flea market, so this is what it's like.
Okay, so what does your typical Boysenberry Festival have outside of, well, boysenberries? You got your arts and crafts.
Boysenberry flavored jewelry.
that's the actual woodworking.
There's things in here.
You can carve it from a log.
It's a boysenberry.
Ooh, candles.
Oh my god, boysenberry tikis.
This qualifies as world's cutest tiki.
Livestock on display.
Boysenberry sheep, boysenberry goats. And the illustrious boysenberry horse.
There is a presentation on the history of the boysenberry in Town Hall.
And everything else the park normally offers.
There goes the boysenberry roller coaster.
Boysenberry knives. Boysenberry death. Actually, I think boysenberry death is what we call like eating too much here.
How are you, boysenberry wife?
Good, boysenberry husband. How are you?
Well, I'm gonna have berries!
And of course, the food.
Boysenberry gummies and boysenberry rock candy.
Ooh, nice.
Don't eat the fork, dear.
It's a boysenberry fork.
Okay, it seems that we have severely underestimated the Boysenberry Festival at Knott's Berry Farm.
You know how there's that Internet of Things? How everything has to have like a Wi-Fi connection with zero security and encryption?
Yep.
This is like that, but with boysenberries. It's the boysenberry thing of things.
Boysenberries of things.
But as we're lowly theme park workers, sometimes, the tasting card was a budgetary must, and fortunately included most of the dishes that piqued our interest.
Boysenberry barbecue meatballs.
Well, here are the illustrious balls of meat.
You may have one meat sphere.
They're piping hot. Mm. Meatball is a standard meatball, like Swedish meatball, but pairs really well with the barbecue sauce.
Yes, they do.
Mm-hmm.
I want more.
I'll pay for more. All right, you have picked that plate clean.
Yeah, I give this a glowing recommendation. Holy.
So here we have the boysenberry
fry bread,
which you describe the fry bread as something more of like a...
Well, the dough is kind of like a beignet, where it's like a light fried dough that can be sweet or savory.
It's like a cinnamon sugar, like topping.
Well, we did get it from the churro factory.
All right, here we go. It's almost chocolatey.
Let me try.
You can try more of the little filling. Yeah, it's like a boysenberry chocolate filling.
And this should be right up my alley.
Too bad I...
It's so good.
I approve.
I'm going to eat the rest.
So here they are, the buffalo boysenberry buffaloes.
But look at the portions. Like, for $25, that's not bad.
And he gets six of different kinds of these.
Yeah. All right, I will let you do the honors first.
Thank you. These are huge buffalo wings, too, by the way.
But unfortunately, they are bone-in. You prefer the boneless.
Yeah. Hot. Mmm. Really tasty on the back end. Barbecue saucy.
Okay, so not a fan then?
I like the aftertaste though.
Tis my turn. I'll get one of the ones that was just kind of sitting there for a while.
Have more time for the juices to seep in.
Mm-hmm. Mmm. Yeah, I get what you mean about the whole barbecue sauce. It does taste more barbecue saucy. There's the spice.
Yeah, I get you on the back end.
It is right there on the back end. It's so good.
So here we have the boysenberry raviolis. The chef herself said that they look kind of funky.
I
don't disagree with her.
But they still look like they're going to taste delicious. I'm going to put some of this Alfredo.
Yeah.
Over.
I love me some Alfredo.
Ooh, very good Alfredo.
Yes. Nice and rich, too.
You first, obviously. Really good?
Oh, yeah. That boysenberry adds the perfect amount of sweetness.
All right, so we're dealing with, like, rich and sweet at the same time?
Yes.
With a little bit of salt?
A little bit of, like, acid.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
It's like someone accidentally mixed the boysenberry punch in, like, a ravioli film.
I'm not complaining.
No, me neither.
It is. Stupid good.
Is that what you want? Is that what you want?
Yes.
There's the closer look at the filling. It's falling down.
Now get it. All right, ready for
the some... Alfredo's the best part.
Yeah. I really like that filling. And it's good with the Alfredo.
What would you pair it with, though? That's the thing.
White wine. and maybe an arugula salad.
That is how you do it.
Thank you, sun, for coming out and beaming right down on it like it's something
heavenly.
Sent straight from heaven. The boysenberry panna cotta, and we have to use spoons now.
This time. Get a little bit of everything here.
Got some granola, got some whipped boysenberry cream. Sauce, whipped cream. Good.
And it is my turn now to venture deep within the... Now, full disclosure, I don't know what panna cotta is.
It's like a thick, creamy pudding.
Okay.
It's so creamy and tasty.
Thank you very much. So this is the one that I'm a little more skeptical about.
I'm all for it.
And you were saying that your mother makes something very similar to this?
She makes this salad with like an arugula mix and raspberry vinaigrette and some like toasted walnuts. And this smells a lot like that salad.
Yeah, it's got like fresh arugula on there. I think I see some almonds. There's
almonds,
some...
cheese. Looks like either a goat cheese or a...
I think it is a goat cheese.
A soft cheese of some sort.
And then, of course, you got the boysenberry whatnot.
And looks and toasted ham? Onions and ham.
All right, let's take this over there. And
ooh, that sauce is good.
Take it over here and try it out. All right, so as always, Haley, you go first.
It's my kind of pizza. I love a salad pizza.
Yeah, it really is more of a salad pizza.
It's also kind of not intensely hot.
Yeah, it is. We are rocking the cold college pizza here, so.
Which I don't usually like cold pizza, but as a salad pizza, it works.
But I mean, the more that that ham just kind of sits there and marinates, it's like, it kind of makes up for the rest of the dish.
And also the cheese and the sauce together.
Yeah.
Really good.
I think I accidentally got a little boysenberry on my nose.
Nice dip.
And those were the tasting card offerings, and for $25, it was a pretty good bargain, even for two people. The portions were decent outside of the pizza and the fry bread, but my favorites out of the bunch were definitely the more savory dishes. The pizza sounded good on paper, but piled that high with arugula, I receded back to my typical five-year-old taste profile.
I don't like green food.
Haley, on the other hand.
My top three is the ravioli, the pizza, and the panna cotta.
But I'm still hungry. I'm gonna go get more food. Gator bites.
All right, food's great and all, kids, but ain't nothing beats boysenberry punch. Absolutely nothing. Anyway, back to the food.
Reptile.
We ran into an interesting conversation while we were at the counter.
A child, roughly the age of 12, is like, what's gator bites? I'm like, exactly what it says on the tin, Sonny Jim. Alligator. Reptile, native to the southeastern United States. Tasty.
And with it, of course, we have the
boysenberry aioli. And here we go.
Is you home?
I is home. It's so buttery.
Buttery?
Buttery.
Like it's got a buttery fry on it?
Mm-hmm. Nice buttery fry.
Speaking of fries.
No!
How dare you?
But this right here, kids. This is the boysenberry ketchup. I will try this first.
What?
It's just ketchup with a hint of boysenberry.
I won't try it now. Yeah.
Like it's almost so ridiculous.
I've been working. I can't really taste like it. I mean, it's like a thing.
All right, remember back in the 90s?
A little bit of this and a little bit of this.
Now it's my turn to try the gator bites.
Eat the dinosaur. If it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Mmm.
Yeah. Buttery, right?
That's delicious. That's better than a chicken. These are better than chicken nuggets.
Gator
for only
nuggets.
$10, that is a steal right there.
Yep. Especially because gator is not native to Southern California.
Mm-hmm.
Not in a food capacity, at least. You have to wait till gator season in Louisiana.
This is ridiculous. This is almost pushing it. Like, boysenberry barbecue sauce, I can understand.
This is just for the novelty right here.
Because that's all it is. I'm going to try it with the ketchup. Which I know is sacrilege, but...
I'm going to try the aioli for the french fry.
Mmm.
Mmm. You know, it's like a shrimp sauce or a lobster sauce almost.
Yeah. I think it kind of enhances like the buttery flavors. The verdict on the gator bites.
Oh yeah.
Verdict on the boysenberry aioli.
Oh yeah.
Verdict on the ketchup.
y'all need to go home.
Like I'll even understand boysenberry beer and boysenberry popcorn and cotton candy. Cause you're just accentuating sweet. This, there's nothing supposed to be sweet about this. This is not supposed to be sweet.
The ketchup is just pureed tomato and vinegar.
It's like the tastes are fighting for supremacy in my mouth.
Neither one really wins.
No. But of course, we're not done.
Nope.
I'm starting to lament this decision.
We gotta do the grand finale.
We have one more. One more hill to die on.
Let's go to Flop House, get ourselves a fun.
Yeah, we're literally not kidding when we say, like, yeah, come on down to the Flop House and get yourself a fun bun. That's it.
It is. It's that big. It's the size of my
for
hand.
For comparison, here's the ketchup. Oh. Oh. Pray for us, folks. So what, you get half, I get half.
You can take a bit out of the center. I think I've crescent mooned it a bit.
Okay.
That's a good sauce, though.
All right, let's
taste some of that sauce.
You said it was cream cheese?
Like, it said, like, cream cheese.
Oh!
Wow.
Yeah, it's like a glaze.
That is... All right, that's the best tasting thing I've had all day.
And then you get all some right. of this gooey stuff in the middle. This.
Good?
Mm-hmm.
All right. My turn. Oh, no.
Well, you dealt it.
I did. I accidentally got that big of a piece. All right, here we go, kids.
Mm. I'm gonna try and get some of this fry on the outside.
Yeah, yeah. That is immaculate.
Yep, yep. I feel my arteries clogging. Worth the sacrifice.
Grabbing a bit of the outside now.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, 1 minute until our next performance. Oh. Boys and Mary Bell, comedy melodrama good for audiences.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. This is
classic. This is classic State Fair stuff.
It's so good.
How have we already gutted it?
I don't know how. Give me ears for it.
How much time has passed?
This should not be as appetizing as it is.
We're doing this for you. So you don't have to. Our sacrifice.
You should do it.
Our sacrifice is for your benefit. I don't know if I'm starting to see dead kings because of this. But I'm getting close. That's some nice cream cheese on there. You're tapping out. I can't finish that.
I've eaten my half, honey.
Ugh.
Come on, you're leaving the best part. That is the best part.
I'm saving it for last.
Okay. If we go to the wine tasting after this, we ain't gonna get drunk for nothing.
If we go to the wine tasting after this,
we've already eaten drunk. Our drunk food.
I'll get drunk so I can puke it all up so I can have more. That's a brilliant idea. I'm gonna do this.
You can do this. It's not gluttony if you clean your plate.
Oh, this is 100% gluttony.
Last one, trooper. Last bite.
In the name of Walter, Cordelia, and Charles Schultz,
amen.
I deem this bun
fun and done.
Yay! We've conquered it. You've conquered it. You've won, Adrian. Now that's Rocky.
This is such a Pyrrhic victory. I don't feel like I've accomplished anything except being fat on camera. Hey, at least we got ketchup out of it.
After that, we were made privy to the Boysenberry cream soda by Dave.
Say hi, Dave.
Hi, everyone. I'm here too, because of course I am.
No, it's glass.
No, it's not. It's plastic.
It's a sturdy glass.
It's fake glass.
Oh, that's heaven.
It's really rich, though. It's really tart.
Well, the tartness is the blueberry or boysenberry. But yeah, you get like the distinct creaminess of a cream soda too. So,
tastes like that liquefied panna cotta.
Then we didn't go on any rides and just farted around the park for a bit.
I have seen so much. Why?
All right, I had to do a second take of this because that kind of looks like Delibird. I know it's not, but I still blame you for it, Garrett.
And that was the 2017 Boysenberry Festival, and overall, I'd say it was a lot of fun. A lot of that was in new culinary discoveries, but there wouldn't be much of a festival without that. If, and certainly when, you have the ability to come to California, definitely check this out. You'll have a very good time.
Okay, I'll stop. That about does it for this.
Like, share, subscribe if you like boysenberries. I know I do.
Well, hello there. Allow me to welcome you to the end of this video. And yes, I am drinking boysenberry coffee out of a Figment mug. So glad you noticed.
God, I look horrible in that footage. Anyway, let's redo this outro. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked it, go ahead, click the like button down below. Leave a comment. If you want to see more, go ahead, click the subscribe button. Ring the bell for all future notifications and uploads. Definitely have a lot of good stuff coming, especially with May the 4th coming up.
Yes!
Oh, yeah. If you want to support the channel monetarily, you may do so over on Patreon. Links are down in the description and will be at the end card. One of the perks you get outside of early sneak peeks at videos is seeing your name scroll by on screen and read aloud by me if you are a newcomer, such as Drew the Poet and one other. Okay. And at the $10 or more level, you get your name in sparkly lights! And I'm forgetting someone, aren't I? I don't know what you're talking about. It's totally Bailey. Stubby tail and everything. Like I said, at the $10 or more level, you join the Cool Cats Club and get your name in sparkly lights and different colored font. That's about the best I can think of right now. And appearance by Bailey, or Bailey Scent Double in this case. He's asleep. And those amazing people are Christopher, newcomer Danielle Garcia, Dylan Van Voren, Jerry Callahan, Kevin J. Gabriel, Maverick Myries, Morgan LF, and Tony Goldmark. Any amount will help. You can cancel anytime, and even during these interesting times, I wouldn't begrudge anybody for choosing not to do so. I also got approved for the YouTube membership program recently. If you have any suggestions for emojis or perks there, go ahead, drop them down in the comments below or on Patreon if you are so inclined. Again, thank you so much for watching. Like, share, subscribe, all that good stuff. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay awesome. And as always, bonus nachos, kids. It's so weird.
And of course, boysenberry executions.